past the flattened farmhouses amid the date palms, craters left by roadside bombs, positions fortified with sandbags line the now tranquil road.
The ISIS fighters even dug trenches that lead all the way up to these fighting positions.
Since June, ISIS was only pushed back 3 miles along this particular battle line in Anbar province, just west of Baghdad. And it took months for the Butter Corps, a paramilitary force that is part of the predominantly Shia volunteer army, to break through this line of defense. We tried to advance from the front, Raad Tamimi says, but we couldn't, so we flanked them from behind. And that was only after a joint operation that included air support and Iraq's conventional forces. But as is the ISIS tactic, buildings like this former school were booby-trapped. One of the bomb disposal unit members killed when he tried to defuse the explosives in front of the gate.
There's a home that you can see in the distance. Right behind that is where ISIS has its closest positions to this particular area.
The road here leads into the town of Garma, still firmly under ISIS control. Targeting, we are told, comes from imagery captured by drones, equipped with thermal cameras, provided to the fighters by Iran. They were brought with the Iranian advisors. They are the ones who taught us how to fly them, Moin al-Kadumi, one of the commanders, says. Iran's role, he argues, has been positive, quick to respond while the U.S. and its allies hesitated to act. But, he says, coalition strikes can help them in Anbar. The coalition can help us by targeting the border areas that ISIS operates in and in the desert, al-Kadumi says. Iraqi army artillery batteries are scattered throughout the fields, staring down the enemy. Watchtowers now line key roads as forces await orders for what is expected to be a massive joint operation in the next phase of the battle against ISIS. Arwa Damon, CNN, Anbar Province, Iraq.